Hey all, it's Drew, and we're back with another film breakdown video. Today we're going over Liberty playing Coastal Carolina in this crazy ending and the play that everyone's been talking about. Before we get started, I need you guys to subscribe. I need you guys to like the video. And I need you guys to comment down below on what bowl game you want to see next. There's a bunch of fun games moving forward, and I want to help you guys out in the film analysis. So just comment down below. It's really easy. But as for today's video, let's go. Let's start today's film breakdown on when the game gets really exciting, and that's when Coastal Carolina is making its comeback. They're down by 8, fourth quarter, they're needing a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie the game, so they call a nice little slant concept on the offense. The defense has a short zone, the slants are able to get to the back of the end zone, and with multiple hitches and probably a late decision, we do have a touchdown. So here we go, first exciting play of the game, two-point conversion, needing for the tie. I want you to look at this formation real quick. We got tight ends on either side, a wide receiver short motion, and the fullback and running back are shaded to one side. So they run the speed option to that side. Now, if you would have seen earlier in the game, 19-31, Carolina does the exact same thing. Tight ends on either side, wide receiver short motion, the fullback and running back are shaded to one side. They have the speed option to that side, fake to the running back touchdown. So maybe if Carolina or Liberty, mind you, would have done some film analysis in the middle of the game, they might have been able to see that we're doing speed option to that side and the quarterback really likes to take it himself. And so number 6 does not take too far of an angle upfield to miss the tackle for the touchdown, well, the two-point conversion. But it's okay because Liberty tied in the game, drives down the field. Carolina has no timeouts left. First and goal. A minute 35 left, all you got to do is just run the clock out. That's all you got to do, and you will win the game off of a last second field goal because you have a timeout. And so now is where people have been arguing on Twitter and everywhere on whose fault was this. Was this the coach's fault? Was this the running back's fault? Or was this the tight end's fault who pushed his man into the end zone? Well, I want to say that the blame should not get put all on the coach. I do say number one is the coach because you should just call a quarterback kneel and not risk anything off of a handoff exchange, a fumble, etc. But the coach should not be blamed all. I'm going to put about 75% blame on the coach because the first play was this. It was the running back getting the ball and standing still with the defense allowing him to move forward, but he does not. Almost as if he is coached to do this. And so if the coach sees play one goes well, he does not go and score and he sits down right after he's about to get tackled. So then the coach says, hey, he does this on the sideline. He says, run it back. He says, I've coached you once. I've seen you do it once. So how about you just do it again? And so, yes, he should have already called a QB kneel on play one. But when it's worked one time, you kind of just say, let's roll it again. And that's when the other 25% moves on to the running back and tight end. I give 20% to the running back because when you get the ball right here and you make a jump cut and you move forward and give up your body on the 3-yard line when you received it on the 7-8, that's your fault. And then when he goes in and you try to pull it back and not get tackled and then you fumble the ball, yeah, that's the running back's fault. But you got to put a little bit of blame on number 88, who is going to push his man into the end zone. Why are you pushing him into the end zone? You don't want to score. And when the ball is trying to be released backwards and not, he doesn't want to score. He wants to not let it get in. And then you get tackled and then he fumbles the ball. He kind of forced that fumble. A touchdown would have been fine. But it's all okay because through a lot of miscues on Coastal Carolina's part and three and outs, field goals, we try to tie it. Liberty comes up with the block. And all is forgotten. Head coach Hugh Freeze, he is not to blame. Super excited. Liberty beats Coastal Carolina, gives them their first loss. And number 8 is doing snow angels on the side of the field. He is just so excited that it is not his fault for the loss. So that was such a fun game to watch in real time. I hope you guys enjoyed this film breakdown video. If you did, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. If you guys want to see more film breakdown videos on bowl games, put it in the comment below. But that's all I have for today. I'll see y'all in the next one.